In this video, we'll be taking a look at how to integrate Docker containers with Windows subsystems for Linux and VS Code to make container development easier. For the project that I've been working on recently, my next step is to try to bundle the web app components that I've built into a containerized application. I haven't done much of this before, so the first step was to try to figure out what I needed to build into a development environment for containers. After some quick research, I found out what I was hoping for, which is that there is an integration for Docker into Windows Subsystems for Linux, or WSL, which means that I didn't need to build any other sort of VMs or container hosts to run my Docker applications just for development and testing. So in this video, we'll walk through pretty quick just what that install and setup looks like, and how easy it can be to get started with Docker using VS Code and WSL. So as you can see on the screen right here, we do have the Docker documentation page for how to get started with Docker Desktop with the WSL backend. The one thing I just wanted to point out on this page is that you will need a specific version of Windows 10, and you will have to be running WSL2. Now, if you're not sure what version of WSL you're running, one way we can check real quickly is to open up Windows PowerShell, and we'll type in WSL-L-V for listing and verbose. And in my case, you can see I have exactly one instance of WSL built today that I'm using. It is a Debian image that is currently running, and it does show that it's version 2, so we're good to proceed with that image. Next, we're going to scroll down just a little bit just to grab the download link, and we'll go ahead and click that and get over to the download page. Easy enough, all we got to do is click Get Docker and wait for the download to complete. This will take just a second. All right, once that download is complete, we'll go ahead and click on the installer to begin the installation of the Docker desktop client. And since we're intending on using this with WSL2, we do want to make sure that the configuration checkbox for install required Windows components for WSL2 is checked. Lucky for us, that is the default, so we'll just leave it as is. All right, once that install is completed, we can go ahead and hit close. Next, we're going to jump over to VS Code, where the next step that we're going to need to do is go ahead and install the Docker extension for WSL2. And so on the left side of VS Code, we'll see the little extensions icon. We'll click on that. We will search for Docker. And the first link is going to be the Microsoft package for Docker integration. We'll go ahead and click install on WSL Debian, since that's the image I'm using. This install is actually pretty quick. Once we're done with that, we'll hop back over to our Explorer. So in order to test this, we'll build a quick Nginx container just to host a simple web page. So in order to do that, we'll create two files. The first is going to be index.html, which will contain the text data that we're going to display on the page. And next, we'll also create a Docker file that's going to contain the configuration for the container itself. Starting with the index.html file, we'll just go ahead and put in hello there, built from our container. We'll save that file and we'll move over to the Docker file. Now, since this is going to be a pretty lightweight test, we're only going to need two lines in our configuration file. However, I did want to show that VS Code now does the command completion and autofill to help you out in building this config file. Makes life just a little bit easier, especially if you're like me and you're a little bit more unfamiliar with how to build containers. The first thing we're going to do is specify the base image that we're going to build our container off of. So as you can see, once we start typing from, VS Code already prompts to show that the correct usage is going to be from and then a base image. And once we begin typing in the base image name of the container that we intend to use, in my case, Nginx, only the first two characters are required for it to pop up the autocomplete. This is going to show a list of base containers that we could use from the Docker registry. We have any number of images that we could use, but I'm just going to be using the official Nginx image, so we'll just autocomplete that and move on. Next, we're going to need to specify that we are copying our index.html file into the proper web directory on our container. So we'll do that using the copy command. And again, as we start typing, we will see that VS Code will prompt us to show that the correct syntax is going to be copy the source file or folders, followed by the destination. So real quick, we'll just put in index.html, and we'll be copying that to the Nginx HTML directory within our container. Now, not everything we're doing is limited to just within VS Code. When we installed the Docker components earlier, this did install a desktop client that we can go ahead and open. And if we look here, we can see that there are no containers and apps currently running, And we can also jump down to the images and see that we currently have no local images stored in our Docker environment. So to make building containers simpler, we don't even have to go look up what commands might be required to compile our container. Instead, within VS Code, we can right-click on our Docker file and click Build Container, and VS Code will handle that for us automatically. It will prompt us to go ahead and tag what we want our image as, but for now, I'll just go ahead and leave that as the default. Using that build function, VS Code is going to go ahead and download the base image that we're working off of, which is the official Nginx image, and then it'll go ahead and apply any additional configuration settings we have to that container. In this case, our only configuration is that we're copying our index.html file to the Nginx web directory, and then it'll finish by compiling all of that into a brand new container that we can use for our testing. All right, once our container's built, we can go ahead and click on the Docker icon on the left side of VS Code. That's going to take us to a new tab that is going to show us all of our current running Docker containers, available images, any registries that we're connected to, and the Docker networking, all of which we can manage and see straight from VS Code. And under images, we can see that we have our Docker test image, and we can expand that and see that we have the build latest that we just completed a couple of seconds ago. And if we wanted to go ahead and test our container, all we have to do is right-click on our image and click Run. That will go ahead and start that container locally within the Docker engine. Now we have a couple of things we can do. For example, if we want to make sure that our file was copied correctly, we can go up under Running Containers, right-click, and click Attach Shell. This is going to give us a bash shell running in our container so that we have command line access to go ahead and check to make sure that our file is there. So we'll go ahead and check real quickly. And yep, that looks good, just what we'd expect. And so next we'll go ahead and launch a web browser to go ahead and see that everything is working as we intended. Again, in our Running Containers inventory in the upper left corner, we can right-click on our running container and just click Open in a Browser. And that'll go ahead and pop up my browser locally and redirect automatically to the URL of our container. And sure enough, we see the text that we had put in our HTML file. We can also jump back over to that Docker desktop client and see what is being shown in there now. Since I left this on the Images tab, we can see that we do have our local repository. Shows our Docker test image that I just built, and it shows that it's in use and running. If we go ahead and switch over to the container slash apps tab, we're also being shown here that there is that container running. It is running on port 80. And similarly to VS Code, we'll have our options here if we wanted to go ahead and open this in a web browser and view the page, or if we just wanted to pop a CLI bash shell to run commands locally on the container. All that being done, once we're done, we can hop back over to VS Code. We can right-click on a running container and go ahead and click Stop. Okay, and that's about it. I just wanted to take a couple of minutes to show what the Docker integration to VS Code and WSL looks like, and how easy it can be to make container development a little bit simpler. All right, and thanks for watching.